Hi, everybody. I'm Candace Rudardi, Relationship Marketing Coach. And today I'm going to share with you a little bit about send out cards. Basically, what I'm going to do is try to send as many greeting cards as I can in 10 minutes. So, Randy, start your timer. All right. First thing you do is you log into the send out cards website, which looks like this. Send out cards is a greeting card and gift website. So we have gifts and greeting cards. Greeting cards come in all shapes and sizes. We've got 5x7 folded cards. We've got 5x7 flat cards. We've got 5x7 three panel cards, which means that the card's actually 7x15 both sides. So you've got 2 7x15 panels. We've got big cards that are 8x10, and we've got postcards that are 4x6. So all sorts of different greeting cards, and we have all sorts of gifts. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to log into my account. I'm going to go to my how many cards I've sent this month, because I want to see how many cards I can send in the next 10 minutes. So I'm going to filter by date in my card history. I'm going to go July 1 to July 22nd and hit submit. And it looks like I have sent 88 cards this month. So 88 is the magic number that we're going to subtract from the ending number. Okay. So now I'm going back to the card catalog. There's a reason why I'm doing this, because it doesn't take very long to send cards. Now I'm going to send a card with a photo from lunch the other day. So what I did was I selected a build my own card with my own photo. I'm going to customize it. I'm going to make it a two panel card on standard paper. I could upgrade to satin or pearl, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to keep it a two panel card in standard paper. I'm going to hit the next button and wait for it to load. Sometimes you can't control what the internet does. Sometimes you just have to talk through it. All right, so it's loading. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click the little camera right here. And I'm going to grab a photo that I've already uploaded, or I could upload the photo down here, but I thought it would just be more time effective if I uploaded the photos ahead of time. So here's a picture I took at lunch the other day. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger, and I'm going to go over here to the text box, and I'm going to write Lakeshore lunch with an exclamation point. And then I'm going to grab that text box and I'm going to move it to the center of the picture. I'm going to highlight the font. I'm going to make the font a different font, something fun like Changa 1. And then I'm going to go down to more colors. I'm going to change the color to BNI red. So there, Lakeshore Lunch in BNI red, kind of in the middle. Then I'm going to go to the inside of the card. And then the upper top part, I'm going to change the layout to a photo, a full size photo. So I clicked on layout options, and now I'm selecting the full size image layout. I'm going to click on the camera, add the photo. There's the photo. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger and move it around. There we go. And then down here, I'm going to say, hey, and then I'm going to go down here and I'm going to insert first name. That means everybody who receives this card is going to have it personalized to them, but I'm not going to personalize it. The system's going to personalize it. It was fun to see your face, Candace. All right. So now that's the inside of the card. I'm going to highlight, oops, I spelled my name wrong. I'm going to highlight the font, change the font to something more fun. Like, the surfer one, original surfer. And I think I'll make it a little bit bigger up here. You can change the size of the font by clicking on this button over here. Okay. So there's that. And then the back of the card has my custom branding on it. I'm not going to change my custom brand right now, but I do have about 25 different custom brands that I've created, and you can brand your business however you want. So those are some of the brands that I have, but I'm just going to keep it the one that I have on the back of the card right now. Okay. So now I'm going to save and proceed to checkout. And then while we're waiting for it to load, Loading. It doesn't take that long. Now I'm going to add recipients. So I'm going to click on the add recipient button, and then I'm going to try to remember everybody who was in the picture. So, and again, sometimes the internet works fast. Sometimes the internet works slow. You just have to be patient. Okay. So Amy was in the back. So let's add Amy. Oh, it looks like I have a lot of Amy's. So Amy Krenz. There you are. And then next to Amy was Anne. I hope I remember everybody. You know what? There might be an easier way to do this. I'm going to make this easier on myself. Instead of doing it this way where I'm doing it one at a time, I'm going to pick a group. So what groups are, A group is a group of people that you send cards to regularly. So you put them in a group. So B and I. All right, so here is my Lakeshore Business Professionals group. So I'm just going to go ahead and select that and click done. Now, everybody in that group is going to get this card, except I don't want to send it to everybody in the group. I want to delete some of the people. So I'm deleting Cody because he's not in our group anymore. Value is there. Chris was not. Nate, were you there? I don't think Nate was there. Michelle was there.
Not.
Randy was there for a minute, but he's not in the picture. Andrew was there. Kevin was not there. Again, the internet. You cannot control the internet. So Kevin, deleting Kevin. Deleting Mark. Deleting. See, this is going to mess me up. Deleting. Now I'm not going to be able to send as many cards because things are taking a little bit longer than they should. Anne is in here twice, so I'm going to delete one Anne. But see, isn't this a lot faster than trying to find everybody? There's Lance. I need to update this group because some of these members are no longer in the chapter. All right, I don't want to mess up my time because I want to be able to send more than just this card. So I'm going to go ahead and send this card, knowing that I can come back later and cancel the ones that I don't want to go to. So later today, I'm going to come back and cancel. All right, so that's that. Those cards are out the door. They're going to be printed, stamped, and mailed for me. So now what I want to do is do my birthday cards for October. So I'm going to go to my relationship manager. So I've already done my August and September birthdays, so that's why I'm doing October. I'm going to go up here to search filter, and I'm going to I'm going to go to birthday, and then I'm going to go over to October. I'm going to click 1 to 31. Oops, 1 to 31. So that means everybody with a birthday in October is going to pop up. Waiting for the internet to do its thing. Let's see how many people I have in October. So 33 contacts, going to select all. And then I'm going to go up here to campaign and click on campaign. And I'm going to select my 2021 Star Wars birthday card campaign, Star Wars birthday card campaign. And everybody that I just selected is now going to receive that card. So let me show you what this campaign looks like. Here's the front of the card. Where it says first name, their first name is going to be there because that's a mail merge, just like Microsoft Word or any of those programs. It's a mail merge. First name gets replaced with their first name. The inside of the card has three panels. It's a spread across the board. The inside flap has a message from me. Again, insert first name. It's their name, not insert first name. And there's the branding on the back of the card. So 33 people are getting this card. I'm going to click ready to send. And now these cards are queued to be printed, stamped, and mailed for me in October, 7 days before their birthday. And I don't have to think about it. The cards just go out automatically. How much time do I have? Can I send one more card?
Yeah, you have about 2 minutes.
Okay, one card. I can do it in 2 minutes. So I'm going to go back to my relationships. I'm going to put in the zip code 49443. Is 49443 a zip code? All right, I've already done that one. 49444. Is that a zip code? So now everybody in my address book that has the zip code 49444 is going to get a card. Waiting for the internet to do its thing. Here it goes. When you're trying to be fast and you have to rely on the internet. Okay, so here's everybody with the zip code 49444. I'm going to select all, and then I'm going to unselect John and unselect Morgan because she doesn't live there anymore. Unselect River because he's a kid. Unselect the double Andrew. Looks like everybody else is good. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to send everybody here my B&I campaign. So this campaign right here is an introduction to you. So everybody in the 49444 zip code in my address book is going to get a card from me that talks about you. And that card looks like this. So the front says, how you doing? First name, merge field. The inside has a list of people in our chapter and a note from me talking about how I hope they're having a great summer. And I would love to introduce them to one of these professionals that I know, like, and trust. And then the back of the card again has my branding. So I'm going to go ahead and send that. Ready to send. Okay, so that's going to go out tomorrow. Printed, so stamped, and mailed for me. So let's see, how many cards have I sent? Nope. Got to go to card history. Let's see how many cards I sent in 10 minutes. So we're at card history. Do the filter of the date, January 1. And I'm going to go to 31 because some of these cards are going out tomorrow. So 156. Ladies and gentlemen, this system is so simple to use. You can do that in a short amount of time, and your clients will feel like you love them, and it only took you a few mouse clicks. I've been Candace Bedardi, your relationship marketing coach. Thanks, guys.